Hi, I'm Alex with Kimray. Today we're going to install and calibrate a Valvcon electric actuator with an R2L adapter on a 2-inch Kimray high pressure control valve. For this process, you will need a 7/16 wrench, a 1/2 inch wrench, a 1/16 Allen wrench, a 3/16 Allen wrench, a termination screwdriver, and a loop calibrator. Mount the Valvcon to the R2L with the included bolts. Remove the cover with the Allen head wrench. As you remove the cover, be careful to keep it aligned with the base. Many times the manual override comes off with the cover and the stem can damage the electronics on the back of the board. Make sure your limit switch is on the smart mode selection. This actuator has universal power capabilities. For this video, we're going to be setting it up with the 24 volts DC power and controlling it with 4 to 20 milliamp analog signal. Terminate 24 volt power to terminals 19 and 20. Connect the 4 to 20 milliamp loop calibrator to terminals 15 and 16. If you're using 115 or 230 volt input power, you'll need to terminate the ground wire onto the grounding lug. We're using an analog signal, but it also has Modbus and discrete signal capabilities. Turn the on-off control mode selector switch all the way clockwise to the analog setting. Make sure that your position control switch is on the 4 to 20 milliamp setting. Now, turn your operation mode selector switch all the way clockwise to the calibrate setting. At this point, you can use the clockwise button in the manual control section to drive your stem closed. Once the stem from the R2L adapter makes contact with the valve stem, you can install the coupling block. Remove the rubber clamp and the battery. Use the clockwise and counterclockwise buttons to drive the valve fully closed and fully open to ensure that none of the cams are making contact with the limit switches behind the control board. If the cams are making contact with the limit switches, the switch trip LED light will appear. Loosen the set screw on the cam and retighten in a spot where the valve can have full travel without making contact with the limit switches. Now we're ready to calibrate the potentiometer. Use your clockwise manual control button to drive the actuator fully closed. Hold the enter button down for 2 seconds until the calibrate LED light starts to blink. Loosen the set screw on the main gear behind the control board and slowly rotate the main gear clockwise while watching the calibrate LED light. The LED light will blink faster and faster as you get closer to calibration point. When the calibration LED is solid, retighten set screw on the main gear, then push the enter button. Now that your potentiometer is calibrated, you can replace your battery. Next, we'll set your smart limits. Turn your operation mode selector switch to the zero setting and hold the enter button down for 2 seconds until the LED starts blinking. Run your valve to the fully closed position. Next, send a 4 milliamp signal to the actuator from your loop calibrator. Push the enter button to lock in your fully closed signal. Now, move your operation mode selector switch to the span setting and hold down the enter button for 2 seconds until the LED is flashing. Use the counterclockwise button to manually drive the valve fully open. Send a 20 milliamp signal to the actuator from your loop calibrator, then push the enter button. If you want the actuator to have a different fail position than fully open or fully closed, turn the operation mode switch to mid, hold enter until it flashes, then set the valve to the desired position and press enter to lock it in. If control signal to the actuator is lost but external power is still applied, the signal fail position selector switch provides options for the actuator. Zero, span, or last, which is the position the valve was in when the signal was lost. The Valvcon actuator is also equipped with a backup battery. If power to the actuator is lost, the power fail control switch provides options for the actuator. Clockwise, in which case the valve will drive fully closed. Counterclockwise, in which case the valve will drive fully open. Or mid, in which case the valve will drive between open and closed, depending on what your mid position has been set to. Before you replace the cover, first take the manual override stem out and put it on the Valvcon. Then attach the cover, keeping it aligned with the base to prevent any damage to the back of the board. Thanks for watching. If you have any further questions, contact your local Kimray store or authorized distributor.